Wealth creation is a continuous journey. Sometimes the awareness is what is important. Because as we've said, it's a journey. My wealth creation journey, I can attest that it started when I joined insurance. I became quite successful in especially medical insurance and all that. Then because of my connections, the market, the stock market was really booming in Kenya. And I started trading. I actually became an agent. But because of the political situations and even the world market crash in 2008, everything went haywire and the market crashed. That's when we had to face the situation. Along the way, I had even bought a BMW, an old BMW, for example, from a relative. Was very comfortable, you know, anything European car and all that. It was very good. Now maintaining it became a problem because, you know, some of these cars you have to buy the right parts, and the dealers are quite exorbitant, and sometimes, to be honest, they are very cornish, if you can call it so. So for you to survive with such a car, you need rapport from your mechanic, and so sometimes you even have to put in old spare parts and all that. Anyway, and all this you are doing just to maintain the part and to look the beat, and you know, you look that you're still successful and all that. Like, I see so many people struggling and surviving, you know, surviving, it's not easy in Kenya. You find somebody in the traffic, they don't even have fuel for their car, and yet they're not bold enough to even use a matatu. You know, you don't have to struggle so hard. Be yourself, be real, and go for your goal, because success creation is a long-term thing. It's not something you just do at, it's like a marathon. So for me, what I did is that I really had to become a buddy to my mechanic. But by the end of it all, I looked at the money I'd spent, you know. That money could have bought me a Range Rover, and I would have lived a better, comfortable life, you know. Cumulatively, that's what I mean. So at the end of the day, what I decided to do is to go for a cheaper Japanese car, and cheap, very cheap actually, less than 1000 cc. So I had to import it from Japan. I even had to use a public means matatu while I was at it. So what I'm telling you is this: most people, when they get employed by either government or even like big banks and multinationals, the first thing young people is they go and buy very expensive cars. And you see these on loan. Maybe you buy a car for 2 million shillings. So you are tied. You have to work your ass off and all that. But don't do that, man. That's not the right route to wealth creation. What you need to do is to look for small deposit. Order a car like for $2,000 from Japan. Then pay the necessary taxes here and there. Then you take the car logbook and go and borrow money. Borrow 600,000 from a bank. Go to a place like Kangemi, you know. Lease some land for maybe 100k, maybe for the full or 6 years, 6 months, or even 1 year. Put up mabati houses. You'll be collecting rent of about 75,000 to 100k. You see, you've already become a landlord and you're paying the mortgage, because it's a journey, you know. You have to start learning the small steps and even doing what sacrifices, you know. You have to sacrifice. Don't just think of going to the new and latest club all the time, you know, or even wearing the most expensive clothes. Because at the end of the day, what matters is your net, yours, not who you associate with. Yeah, because you see, there are like now so many opportunities in this country. You can go and get some land going for $500,000, for example, in Kajiado. Maybe if you put 10%, you can pay the other in installments. You see, by the time you are finishing paying that land in 2 years, it will be worth about 2 million shillings, you know. But if you didn't take that painful step of that small money which you had saved because of putting the mabati houses, you won't have those houses. So don't go blindly thinking that wealth will fall from the sky like manna or whatever, you know. It's that decisive step. Yeah, at the end of the day, it's that which you have planted, is that seed which you have planted, which will become the tree and the fruits that you so deservedly needs, yeah, and require for your journey to success. Don't be like everybody else. Most people, even those who earn even a lot of money, even ask around, even in your company, most people by the 10th day of the month, they are very broke. Why? Because most of their money goes into expenses, just day-to-day expenses. So it's the retro money you plant. It's not what you've earned. It's what you have planted, you know. So plant right. Chanuka uinuke. Have a great and successful journey. Thank you.